Sir, good morning, sir. Good morning, sir. Regarding your meeting with the German Chancellor, we understand that you were able to discuss the drug war, the developments of the drug war with the German Chancellor. May we know if you were able to discuss with the Chancellor the ICC investigation in the Philippines?
Yes, so, you know, he brought it up in the lunch, and he just basically asked the status of that investigation into the drug war in the previous administration. And I explained to him our concerns over jurisdiction that we have explained many times over, our concerns with the jurisdiction of the ICC in the Philippines and why it is why we are not recognizing that jurisdiction and the reason behind that. So I think he just we just wanted to be informed. But I went further beyond just explaining the position of the Philippines in vis-a-vis the ICC. I also went further and said we have actually completely changed the concept of the anti-drug campaign, and which is something that I've said before, even before the election, is that in my view, the enforcement can only take you so far, and we have taken it as far as we can, and maybe in the opinion of some, we've taken it beyond. So kailangan natin tignan is the prevention and the rehabilitation, which is, I think, a different approach. So we have a much different approach, and he listened to my explanation, and I think he was satisfied with that.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Catherine Valente, Manila Times.
Yes, but good afternoon, Mr. President. Good morning, sorry. Sir, can we get your statement on the statement of President Xi Jinping urging the armed forces to coordinate preparation for military conflicts at sea, protect the country's maritime rights and interests, and development of the maritime territory? What's your take on this, Mr. President?
Quite frankly, I don't think there's anything new there. That's what they've been doing already. They have defined the 10-dash line, and they continue, in their view, to defend it. We, for our part, continue to defend what we and the international community has recognized as our maritime territory. So, although he did not, the President Xi Jinping did not state that outright until now, that really has been the policy since I think for years already, for the last 2 or 3 years. So I'm not surprised, but we will have to continue to do what we can to defend our maritime territory in the face of perhaps a more active attempt by the Chinese to annex some of our territory.
Thank you, Mr. President. Julie Aurelo, Philippine Daily Inquirer.
It's not. We cannot hear you.
Use the other mic.
Hindi nag-ano.
Use the other mic.
Ganun din, no? Green. Usigaw mo na lang.
Lakasan mo na lang, boss.
Go nga, ba't nag-green?
Hindi red.
We need to turn off yung isa.
Ayun. Hello, sir. Ayan. Yes, sir. There were reports that magkakaroon po ng meeting next week with the Foreign Minister's, the Secretary of State of the U.S., the Foreign Minister of Japan, and our DFA about yung cooperation between the U.S., Japan, and the Philippines. And there were also reports that may meeting po daw kayo with in Washington next month. Would you mind sharing some of what you want, the outcomes of what you desire in these meetings?
The first, I will be seeing a meeting with Secretary Antony Blinken on Tuesday. But I don't know what are the schedules. Let's ask the Foreign Secretary on the specific itineraries. That wala pa ang confirmed lang na meeting so far as I know is the meeting with Secretary Blinken on Tuesday. Yeah.
Oh, thank you, Mr. President. It's confirmed the Secretary Blinken will be arriving on, I think, the 18th in the evening. Then we will meet on the 19th. And I think he will call on the president late in the day on the 19th, around 5 o'clock. As for Japan, at the moment, it's not confirmed whether they'll be coming or not. But at this stage, we haven't received any confirmation.
Mr. President, ano pa yung outcomes that you, on top of mind, ano yung outcomes that you want from this initial talks po about cooperating with the U.S. and Japan?
Well, of course, we hope the intention is to continue to plan to strengthen the cooperation between the three countries, the United States, Japan, and the Philippines. We will perhaps formalize it, but at this point, that's part of the discussion that we will be having. To exactly what will be put in any such agreement. It is probably just formalizing what we are already doing, which will put a bit more structure to what we will do, as in scheduling and interoperability and the actual joint cruises that we are having. And so that is still in flux. So we have to talk about it some more, and let's wait for the developments that will come from DC, from Tokyo, and here in Manila.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Sir, other topic.
Okay.
Ana Felicia Bajo, GMA News Online.
Kino mo patayin yan?
Sir, may we just get your reaction on the latest tirades of former President Duterte? He said that you are in favor of Chacha because you are pushing for term extension just like what your father did, late President Ferdinand Marcos Sr. And he also criticized, sir, your foreign travels. Ang sabi po niya, pasyal na lang daw po kayo ng pasyal during the latest rally po sa Liwasang Bonifacio, sir. May we get you on that, sir?
Ito yung schedule ko. Saan yung pasyal? This is my schedule for today. Where's the paseo? Wala. You know, yung kasama nyo kami. You know, we don't make pasyal. Even in the places that I know where I've spent a lot of time with, Hindi ko napupuntahan yung mga dati kong pinupuntahan because we're here to do this. And as to the other comments, nako-confuse kasi ako sa KPRRD, papalit-palit eh. So I'll have to examine it further, read it, kasi very quick ko lang narinig ang balita, kanyang mga remarks. So we'll tignan ko muna kung ano ba talaga yung sinabi niya para maintindihan ko, dahil hindi ko talaga naintindihan kasi parang naiiba, bawat salita niya, iba eh. So, I will try to make sense of it.
Sir, magbe-birthday po si President Duterte sa March 28. Meron po ba kayong birthday wish or message for your predecessor, sir?
Well, yes. We will, of course, wish him a happy birthday and many happy returns. At talaga namang, that is, tayo mga Pilipino, ginagalang natin yung mga very important occasions na ganyan. Like I told you before, although there is an official greeting from the office of the president, there will also be a greeting. Personal ko namang kilala si PRRD. So, like I've told you many times before, hindi ako na may personal. Para sa akin, hindi naman madali, pero nahihiwalay ko yung yung trabaho at saka yung personal. So, I don't see a problem there.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Last question. Maricel Halili, TV5.
Hi, sir.
Hello.
Sir, makikihingi lang po kami ng update about the condition of your mother, former first lady. How is she?
Pagaling na ng pagaling. She, today is... lalabas na siguro siya sa ospital. She's scheduled to come out on, I think, Thursday. Kasi ang nangyari, kagaya ng nung bulletin na ilinabas namin, although she was feeling better already, wala na yung, pabawas na talaga yung lagdat niya, by now wala na. Yung mga doktor nag-decide na maiwan muna siya sa ospital habang... binibigyan pa siya ng antibiotics hanggang matapos yung course of antibiotics. So, ang ano nila is, sabi nila sa akin when I last spoke to them was Thursday. So, she's in good spirits. She's the usual mga good signs. Gusto nang umuwi, rinireklamo yung pagkain sa ospital. Marami nang gustong papuntahan, marami nang gustong ano. So, alam mo naman yung kilala niya naman yung mother ko. Siya, ang pinakamahirap para sa kanya yung walang ginagawa. Kaya medyo yun, nandun na tayo ngayon. So as I said, that's a good sign. So I look forward to seeing her when we get back on her feet and out of the hospital. All right?
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Malacanang Press Corps.
Thank you.